The fact that sunlight can't penetrate the deep ocean doesn't mean there isn't light down here. Many underwater species glow in the dark through a process called bioluminescence. Our long history as land mammals, denizens of the sunlit world, hasn't prepared us for the amazing variety of life that evolution has crafted in the deep oceans. Since there's no sunlight down here, there's no photosynthesis. That means there are no plants to feed on. And yet, even here, in a world of permanent midnight, there's a thriving food chain. It begins with a process called chemosynthesis. These microscopic creatures have learned to eat what's pouring out of that vent. A noxious compound called hydrogen sulfide. That thick black smoke provides the chemical energy that makes life possible here. Tiny crustaceans eat the bacteria, and the larger animals eat the crustaceans. One day on some future Earth, these mountains could very well end up above the water. Tectonic forces continue to shape our planet. The future is also another planet. It was a volcano like this one that created the Hawaiian Islands millions of years ago. Planet, there's an iron core. It's nested inside of a larger liquid iron shell. And wrapped over this is the part called the mantle. It's rocky, but hot and viscous. Like a pot of soup cooking on a stove, the mantle is churning. What keeps it moving? Two things: the heat left over from Earth's formation, and the decay of radioactive elements in the core. And this outer layer, the crust, where you and me and everyone we know lives, it's only as thick as the skin on an apple. The mantle drags the solid overlying crust along with it. The crust resists because it's cool and rigid. From time to time, it reaches the breaking point. When that happens, the Earth quakes.